For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications.
Like, share, comment and subscribe.
We are going to see that TP-Link router AC1200, which is a gigabit router MYMO enabled, Arcer C6 AC1200. So I just ordered from Amazon. Let's see this, how this product can be installed and what is this product performance. You can see this has 300 Mbps plus 867 Mbps dual band Wi-Fi router. The brand is TP-Link, and this is the box. Let's open it and see what is there inside the box. Okay, so the TP-Link has box. Let's open it. Okay, it's a gigabit ports, Wi-Fi ports enabled, and see this wireless MYMO gigabit router. Let's open it. Let's see what is inside this box. So this is the box. After opening, it has device, the Wi-Fi device. This is the Wi-Fi device, you can see. Let's open it and see. Okay, this is the Wi-Fi router, and which has four antennas. Okay, this is the how the router looks like, and you can see this four antennas, and you can just enable and see this. Okay, these are the four antennas for TP-Link, and inside what's the content is there. You can see this, it's a manual and one cable to connect for the router, from router to your PC or laptop. One is cable for power cable. You can connect that power cable to that one, and okay, that's the back end of that one, and you can see that's the power port. You can connect it over here. Okay, and there is a cable connectivity, so how you can connect it. You can simply connect that one like this and connect the other end on the laptop. So let's see some how we can connect to the power and check it up, that how we can set up this router. So there is a power button. So you have to press that power button so that the Wi-Fi will be on. So this has a reset button, and it has a WPS button for whenever you wanted to connect the guest Wi-Fi without password. You can press that button and connect the Wi-Fi. So another one is the internet port, and it has a four Ethernet cables to connect to your PC directly from here, which also works as a switch. So overall, this is how the router looks. You can see this in the back end. Let's see what's the voltage of the power. So how much voltage it requires. Power is required 12 volts or 1 amp power is required. So these are the items. You can see this charger, and one is manual, how to set up the manual and cable, and another one is a router with 4 antennas. Let's connect it and see how we can set up that Wi-Fi router. So now I'm connecting power cable, so that is connected to the other end is the power, and switch on the power and connect the cables, or just wait for light to come. So now you can see that the light is glowing over there. After that, Wi-Fi signal and all the signals will come over. Now connect the cable. One, that is the internet cable, you have to connect it. Another one is a normal cable which you can directly connect to your PC for first setup, or you can also use for wired connectivity. Okay, so this is how you can connect, right? So the yellow one is an internet cable, and the white one is the one so which I can connect to the my laptop or here. And now go to so now light is blinking, which means the connectivity is okay. Now go to TP-Link Wi-Fi dot, so that is the URL they will give on the manual itself. And first of all, we have to set up the password for the first time to log in or the secure your network. So now set the password, anything, maybe anything password, whatever the password you want, because the default password most of the times they will keep. So that's why this is the setup which can prevent others to access the portal directly without default password. Okay, now let's go and start the setup now. Okay, so here we are, and set the time zone. So basically I'm in India and Mumbai time zone, so I'm just going to select that one. Okay, click next, and now you can select this one whether you have static IP address or dynamic IP address. Okay, you want to set up the type, so basically I'm using the dynamic one, so let's keep it because if you have directly enabled from the ISP, the ISP will provide you the IP address automatically. You can just say dynamic, or if you have static IP address, you can just click on this static IP address and set up these IP address and gateway, all the stuff. Okay, then click next, just come down for dynamic IP address. I'm just giving over here. So now click next, and here it will ask you what you want to set, like existing, you want to clone the existing MAC address from the older device, you can do that, but I do not have that MAC binding, so I just use the new address. So here you can set up the and two access points with their names. So the first one is the default one they will give, but you can set anything. So in case my network SSID, I'm just giving like Dakshesai over here, and the password you can change it, whatever the password, there is a number by default. So for the time being, for this demo purpose, I'm setting the password is password 8123, something like that. And here the network SSID I'm changing to TechARKIT, and changing the password to password 8123. So I change the network SSID. Next, then the password and the Wi-Fi is almost done, and start. So now the Wi-Fi router will be set up. Okay, now internet is connected and our wired, and let's check it up that wireless clients over here. So because there is no wireless clients right now connected, okay, let's connect and see how it looks like. So this is how we can set up these Wi-Fi router TP link. So now no clients are connected yet. Okay, one wired connectivity is connected over here. You can see that that's the PC is connected. Now let's open the mobile and switch on the Wi-Fi, and it will discover for the Wi-Fi. And okay, let's check it up. Yes, it's coming over here. The first one I'm just going to connect and check it up. Okay. Let's see this, how this let's give the password. We have given the password over there. Is password 8123, password 8123, and connect it. Now it's connected, and just go to some speed test over here and check it up, the speed test. Okay, maybe just go to Google and search for speed test, and check it up, this fast.com. It will give you the performance, how much you are getting. Of course, this depends on your internet bandwidth also. So currently I'm getting 26 Mbps. Let's connect another SSID, and check it up that how much speed I'm getting over here. So let's connect to Tech ARK IT over here. And password. Now connect it. Okay, it's connected. So you can see that that's 5G connectivity. And let's go to speed test and check it up how much speed we are getting. Refresh. So almost 33 Mbps we are getting.
Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.